but even well-respected actors.
Hey guys, come on in, come on in, come on in. At first, God, I wasn't going to go live because I tried to go live earlier and the power went out and it got exceedingly hot and I just started feeling a little bad. So I was like, you know what? I got to cook these pork chops and got to clean the kitchen. So why not, you know, have some motivation from you guys to cheer me on to go ahead and cook that food, girl. But nobody's here yet. So I'm sharing myself out and wait for you guys to come. I'm just going to go ahead and just start cleaning up the kitchen. Do what I do in the kitchen, give something a different scenery. So I know it's been a while since we've been in the kitchen, y'all, but we're gonna do the doggone thing. We're gonna knock out these pork chops. So what I'm doing right now is showing myself out. Just letting everybody know that I am live right now. So I know you guys gonna be coming in. A lot of people are live right now, so just get in where you're fitting in. Yeah, but I'm about to do these pork chops up. I'm going to clean up the kitchen, guys. If you guys come in, I'll see the chat. I'll go ahead and say something. So, but right now, what I'm trying to do is turn this stuff down in the background and go ahead and share myself out. Put this on mute. How about that? OG Brabram, what's going on, bro? I am trying to hang in there myself personally because I tried to go live earlier, and my the electric went out because somebody, the lightning had hit a transformer. But I'm in the kitchen now, and we're going to go ahead and cook up some good stuff here. So, but what I'm going to do right now, guys, is go ahead and clean the kitchen. You guys, come on in. OG Brand Brand says, oh, Carolina, hey, you silly. How, you know what? I looked at your videos today, man. Your stuff is popping. It's popping. I am going to put you guys, the OG Brammer, I'm gonna, you know, put you on my social medias after I get through cooking, because man, I'm just been tired, man. It's just draining. I'm not tired from doing anything extra, because I mean, only thing I did today was really when I got my hair done, and you know, I slept being late because I tried to live stream late last night. But honey, I said, you know what, I don't care, come heck or high water, I gotta get up and cook these pork chops, and I'm gonna do this live. So I was like, well, let me get up and do it now, because finally the air came back on and now it's beginning to get cool. So y'all give me a minute. I'm going to go ahead and drop some of the sounds down in the background so we can get to cooking. All right. So come on in. Drop your links. OG Brand Brand is the mod in control tonight, because y'all, I'm going to bring it to you. Southern style, some grilled barbecue pork chops. I was going to try in the Instapot, but I said, no, we're going to go old school and put it inside the oven. So let me turn everything down. Three people in the building, three thumbs up. Thank you guys so much. And we're going to get to cooking. So give me a minute, all right?
Father of actress Jane Fonda and father of actress Bridget Fonda died on August 16, 2019, at age 79 of lung cancer. Ben Cross, best known for...
Y'all was listening to some of the people that passed away, guys. I don't know if you guys know Angela Bofield. She passed away June 13th. Angela Bofield was one of a famous singer. She sang it, I guess, the late 80s and 90s. And I used to love her song where she's like, I give my love to you or something like that. I remember listening to that as a little kid. And five people in the building, four thumbs up. Y'all going to smash that like button. Y'all know why I'm sitting here. Let me turn around and show you some of the things I got for my birthday. And I'm going to tell you one main reason why I'm probably not feeling so well is the cake, the cake, the cake. Happy birthday, Stacy. You probably can see if I take the top off. I had a little piece of that and all that sugar, y'all. And of course, you know, you got. My degree. I went on for a whole live stream. Auntie Mama says, no sound, no sound. And I felt like a butthole. But how many? I know it doesn't happen, you guys. But anyway, hey, things happen. But you know what? We're going to go ahead. You guys can go ahead and read the whole chat or whatever. I'm right here with Craig Jones says, OG, what's up? Deborah Cabasa, home living, says, no sound. We back in business now, baby. Thank you so much. Hey, Pete, what's up, my brother? Got sound now. Like, share me out. You like what you see right now? Hey, We're gonna do the doggone thing. I'm trying to get through the chat because I'm sweating a little bit. I'm gonna get this fan going, y'all, because the air conditioning is now on, the lights back on, and thank God that they get that electric company got that transformer fixed. But anyway, going right down, and AAP says, no sound, sister. We back in business, my brother AAP. Boom, shakalaka, AAP. Y'all, I'm telling y'all, got some great content creators up in here. Y'all drop y'all links. Y'all in the white. Come back a couple more times. We're going to make sure we a perfect fit. And if you keep coming to Carolina Diamond Production, you like what you see, or to anybody in the blue, come back a couple times. We'll see what we can do for you. But Craig Jones says, no sound. I know everybody telling me no sound. I can understand no sound, but we are back. Prayers Ambassador says, muted. Check your audio. Thank you, AAP, once again, baby. I love you guys. President Bester says, we can't hear you. Can you hear me now? Remember that Verizon commercial? We hear you now. Good. OG Brand Brand says, check out my link I just dropped. It's my new video. I will return back. So what OG Brand Brand is saying, OG Brand Brand is an up-and-coming music creator. He writes songs, and honey, I'm telling you, some of his songs that he's rapping about is lit. He's talking about love. Loving one another, you know what I'm saying? You know, that's positive things that we like to hear. Check them out. Check everybody out in the blue. Guys, please go ahead and drop your links. I'm telling you guys, you got some wonderful content creators. But anyway, I'm proceeding on with the chat so I can go ahead and get these barbecue pork chops inside the oven. I was going to do the Instant Pot, but I was like, man, I don't feel like dealing with that thing because it'd be much easier. But I want to go old school and just throw them inside the oven, okay? But anyway, going down, AAP's telling me no sound. Auntie Mama, what's up, baby? Much love to you, honey. Tell Uncle Daddy I said hello. AAP in the building, 6 thumbs up. You guys go ahead and share me out. It is so good to be back, y'all. And with sound, I want to say, everybody, I love you. Much love, much love. Thank you guys for all the birthday shout-outs. I am still answering a lot of emails and a lot of birthday shout-outs right now. I'm almost done. I'm halfway done. So once when I get out of here, finish cooking a dinner with you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and finish knocking that out. But I want to say much love to you guys for wishing me a happy birthday, which was yesterday. Amen to God be the glory. But keep going down. OG Brand Brand says I don't have no sound. I know y'all hear me loud and clear now. Auntie Mama says hello, everyone in the chat. Tuber chat, what's up, my baby? What's going on? Welcome to the live stream. I hope you guys can hear me clearly now. Yes, it is good to be back and have all my friends and loved ones up in here. Y'all hear me? I didn't feel like cooking or coming on, but I am motivated now. Motivated now. And Tuba Chat says, connect and grow AAP Homestead. Prayers invest at Deborah Cabas Home Living. OG Brand Brand. Auntie Mama's Kitchen. Craig Jones Sr. Cruz Bolero. Hello. So OG Brand Brand says, Carolina, please read the comments in the chat. I am reading the comments in the chat. You want me to go back up? I will. But I think y'all might want me to get these barbecue pork chops inside so we can really sit down and talk, and y'all can see how good that meat just come off the bone. It's gonna be delicious, y'all, because I'm just gonna hook this up Carolina style, y'all feel me? But anyway, Carolina, please read the comments in the chat. You have no sound. I'm back. I have sound. Perez the investor says no sound. AP says, hey, Tuber chat, everybody showing love to Tuber chat. Tuber chat, you silly rabbit, come on. OG Brand Brand is obviously, we are a family already connected, guys. Perez the investor, what's up, my baby? You know what? You keep coming back, you'll be blue real soon, because you know what? I've seen your face time or two. I just might be motivated to make you blue right now. You hang around, we'll see. 6 people have been on 6 thumbs up. Come on, y'all, give me some sevens here. Boom, because y'all know I'm 7-7. Go on and smash that like button, share me out. AAP, how is Mrs. AAP doing and the babies? I hope they're doing awesome, man, because I miss you. I miss you. I miss you. There's been many times I thought I might move to Detroit and just be around y'all too. Y'all are a beautiful couple, and I love you so much. I love all of y'all. Auntie Mama, Uncle Daddy. I mean, you guys are just so important to me. But let me get up out of my feelings and let's get this live stream up and popping. No sound. Yes, I do have sound. Auntie Mama, what you say? Yes, godly love. I love all of y'all with a godly love, a gappy love. Godly love. You got to have God, and you got to love one another. That is the greatest God, greatest commandments. Love him with all your heart and treat folks like you want to be treated. And I truly believe in that. Auntie Mama Kitchen says, love you, and I love you too. Carolina, we can hear you now. Good. I'm glad you can hear me, baby. OG Brand Brand says, AAP, you silly rabbit and with a carrot. And Deborah Cabas Home Living said, hoorah, Marines in the house, baby. Army, whoa, you know, nothing but that military lingo going on right now. Salute to you, baby girl. Salute to you. You know, you're going to always be my best, my battle buddy. Deborah Kabas, Home Living, Hua, AP, Homestead, OG, Brand, you know, bam, kabam, showing that love. Y'all know how AP do it. Boom, shakalaka. I still find myself doing that too. Little, L-I-T-T-L-E. I love that last name, which is mine. And says, hey, how you doing, my friend? Hope everything is going good. Auntie Mama dropping her links. AP says, Deborah, hello. AP says, hey, Auntie Mama showing love. Perez, the investor, says, I definitely muted myself a few times. I feel you on it. You know what? Two things I would tell you when you truly, truly, truly know that you are a bona fide YouTuber. One, you forget to push the top chat, the live chat. Number two, and you go muted. And one more thing, guys, I got to tell you. If you ain't got a channel, strike it. You're blessed. I can't tell you, man. I mean, I have people in the back. It's all right. It's all right. The second one's all right. But don't get that third one, baby. Please don't. Don't get the third one. Don't get the third one. Do everything you can not to get a community strike. But if you do, it's not the end of the world. I mean, boom, one or two strikes, boom. But don't get that third one because you know what? They'll take your channel away. I ain't saying they will because I've seen some people who didn't got a second chance, but you don't ever want to put yourself in that predicament because it'll stress you out. I'm telling you, well, it won't stress you out. You'll get upset. How about that? I like to use better words than stress because, you know, we all go through it. Some stress is good stress. Some is definitely bad, but good stress to keep you motivated, to keep you on your plan, to keep you, you know, to your goals. Now, that's good. Not the kind where you got to like, oh, my God. No, we don't need that. Just, I mean, just because you make a mistake, wipe yourself and boom, jet back on. But anyway, we could talk about, you know, that on another day, YouTube and whatever. Boom. Anyway, send me an email. All these great content creators in here. Boom. No question. No question. We'll go unanswered. If I don't know, somebody else will know. And we'll make sure you get an answer. But anyway, boom, moving on down. Auntie Mama says, yes, baby. Cruz Bolero Perez says, hello. OG Brent says, Carolina, yes, you back in the building. Homestead said, doing good. Thank you, sister. All right. I'm glad you're doing well, my brother. I miss you so much. I can't wait till you come back and start doing your live streaming again. All you guys, man, I miss running eggs. I keep going on, y'all. If I keep naming, I might forget somebody. So please, I'm going to say each and every one of you. I love you guys so much. And it's a pleasure to be back here with some great, wonderful, creative people. But I'm moving right back down. And AAP says, ha, ha, ha. Deborah Kabas Home Living has dropped her link. So you guys, please definitely check her out. Once again, guys, y'all in here, drop your links. Drop your links. That's us promoting you. So we can go check out and see what you're doing. And if you got a special premiere that's coming out even after my live stream or even with my live stream going on, because it don't matter. We sharing the love, baby. That's what we do around here. Go ahead and drop your links. Keeping going down the chat, we got Deborah Kabas Home Living says, I'm still here. Listen, please, baby, stay with me. Stay with me because we're going to get the cooking on, get some finger licking good barbecue pork chops going on. And Jazz says, I hear you, sis. OG Brand says, April Shower, you silly rabbit. OG Brand says, Carolina laughing. I'm glad I'm putting a smile on y'all beautiful faces because I'm telling you, it's been one of those days for me where I didn't feel like smiling. But when I saw y'all, boom, I tell you, I got motivated. I got so motivated. I said, you know what? It don't matter what type of day I had. God is good. He sent you guys. I'm here. There's a reason why we're going to do this thing because it's called motivation and making us feel good with that family, God-driven, agape love. You know what I'm saying? Much love to y'all. But OG Brandman says, Jazz, you silly rabbit with a carrot. Matter of fact, I love carrots too. I just don't eat rabbit, but I got other country people around here that do. Hey, peanut to mama know what I'm talking about. It's wonderful to that heart. Is it wonderful to be here with you? Oh, thank you guys so much. Well, y'all, here's the thing. I got this Instapot. Let me show you guys. I have the Instapot, right? Where you put meat inside, it makes it so easy and computerized. But I don't want to do that. I want to put it in here, glaze it with some baby back ribs, and watch the meat come out the bone. So this is what I'm gonna do. You guys talk, y'all mind, y'all know what to do. I'm gonna wash my dishes already. Now I'll tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and do my meat, wash my meat, and I'm gonna go ahead and season and bring it to you guys. And then once that's on, I'm going to go ahead and clean up my kitchen because even though some of the dishes, I got a few dishes, I don't like cooking with dirty dishes, okay? That's just something that was instilled in me. You don't cook unless you got a clean kitchen. But just to go ahead and get stuff started, because it's going to take about a good hour for it all to come together. And I'm just going to do that so we can sit down and talk, okay? So let me prepare to doing this. You guys drop your links, get to know each other. I'll be talking where you can hear me, but I won't be paying that much attention to the chat till I sit back down. So this is what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and wash my meat, y'all, and I'm going to come over and show y'all what I'm doing, all right? Fair enough? Straight. Drop your links, get to know each other. But first, y'all, I'm going to wash my meat. So that's just something that I was taught to do, and that's what I'm going to continue to do. Who in the world won't cook in a dirty kitchen? I don't know how you do it, and I just don't want to do it. It's going to take me about 5 minutes. Hope you guys are having a wonderful, wonderful evening. Go ahead and drop your links or whatever and get to know each other. And I'm going to turn this fan right this way, y'all. It is been a hot day right now. I think it's probably about 89 degrees right now. And that's great. So go ahead and take the trusty pork chops out. I'm gonna go ahead and do that for right now. So yes, I have I'm gonna do 5 thin cut with the bone in it pork chops, and they're pretty much already unfrozen, so I'm just gonna take them out and wash them. So y'all give me a minute, let me do that, and I'll come over there to you, show what I'm doing. My sink over on this side is clean already. I don't know what that was. But anyway, I got the pork chops out. I'm going to go ahead and continue to wash them. Always wash the meat, people. You do not want to cook any butchery, especially pork. Pork without washing. Always wash all your food, honey. And I'm going to tell you right now. You don't want no salmonella. You don't want none of that crazy mess. And who wants to eat bloody food? Good Lord. I hate that. So definitely wash your meat. I'm washing it real good, y'all. Washing on both sides. And then what I'm going to do right now is slide this over the side and wash my hands off. And what I'm going to do now, this has already been pre-planned. I'm going to wipe it down a little bit. And I'm going to put a lining of foil on it. And the reason why I do that is so you know, the pan don't be so messy, and I can just take the foil, pull it up, and discard it. So what I'm going to do now is just go ahead and put this to the side. You guys notice I have a new stove as well. It's one of those top stoves where, you know, you don't have the actual eye or the actual stove. Old-fashioned rings is just flat down and just nice up-to-date stove. So what I'm doing right now, I'm taking this to run over out. Not that much, just enough that you put it at the bottom. Slide that back under. You know, like that, like nice, like that. Making it nice and neat. Or I can just lay the meat in, you know, after I season it. And oil it down so the meat won't stick. Not too much oil, but I'm using olive oil. You guys can use any choice of oil you want, but I'll be using olive oil as a bottom layer on my aluminum foil. So let's get it. So what I'm doing right now is going ahead and washing the meat. That's already done. I'm getting the seasoning I'm going to use right now is basic right now. Black pepper, salt. I love Lowry's seasoned salt just because it's low in sodium. And I'm going to use some onion salt just a little bit because I'm going to put real onions on top of my meat. And of course, I definitely love a little bit of parsley. Just a little bit. Not too much, but just a little bit. So what I'm going to do now, I'm taking my salt, putting on both sides of the meat. Not too much, because, you know, pork will hold its own. Not too much, just a little bit. And besides, you know, I don't do a lot of salt, but just enough for the people, you know, just coming over to eat so they can taste it. Like, okay, it's enough seasoning here. Just because she don't like salt on me, I'm not putting it too salty. Just a little bit. And then I'm going to proceed. Use my black pepper, do it on both sides. Yeah, doing it on both sides. A lot of people like to use meat tenderizer and seasoned salt and all that. It's okay however you want to use season, but just make sure you do both sides of the meat. God, I need one of those cameras like some of those cookie channels got where you can see everything somebody doing. That's gonna be my next investment in my own. Bless me, Jesus. Excuse me, y'all. That's gonna be the next investment that I do on my YouTube channel. Okay. Next thing I'm putting is on this Lowry seasoning salt, which is 30% less in sodium. I'm just gonna put a little bit on top and a little bit on the back just to bring the more flavor out. And then, oh God, excuse me, y'all. I'm just sneezing that black pepper. Okay, marinating pretty good. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Okay, that's good. And then finally, gonna top it off with parsley on the back and front. I gotta open this, a brand new one, y'all. Just a little bit, just a little bit. Okay, wow, we now this smoke. It's got that smoke flavor to it too. Just a little bit of parsley, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put some smoke bites on here. I'm seasoning both sides. Now here's the thing. A lot of people don't like to put a little bit of oil in there. So the reason why I do mine like that is because it brings out the flavor and it keeps the meat moist. A little trick I learned from my grandma I'm watching. But I'm using olive oil. You can use Western oil, vegetable oil, any type of oil. But the oil that I like to use is called Pipple Vario olive oil. It's called about $9 a bottle down here in the South, but it is very good and healthy. Especially when you're trying to watch your diet or do a lifestyle change like I am. Because I'm back in the gym now, and I used to load myself with that vegetable oil, cheese, and eggs, and all that. Nowadays, just olive oil. And when you light your pan, like I'm about to do now, I'm going to lightly lighten the pan. I'll show you. I'm just going to put about 2 teaspoons of olive oil at the bottom of it just to make sure that my meat is not sticking. So with olive oil, you know, it's a little bit denser, but it's also a whole lot better than the vegetable oil. So just 2 teaspoons, which is like 2 small cupfuls. Put this back up. And what I'm going to do is take my fingers and lightly pan. You guys can see. And make sure we're all there. There we go. And you guys want to know what I got this pan from? I did a Dollar Tree haul. It's not a Dollar Tree haul anymore. It's more like a dollar and a half haul. I got these right here because, you know, they're easy and you don't have to wash them. Just throw them away. But, you know, I'm so used to using my own pans and putting the aluminum foil in there. But long story short, this is what we're about to do. I'm about to put my meat in here. There we go. Oh, God, it is so pretty, too. Yes, I'm just cooking for y'all so that it just perfectly fits and decides, you know, just leftovers for tomorrow just in case somebody want to eat lunch or something. I'm like, you got something to eat, Stacy? I'm like, yeah, some pork chops in the refrigerator. So I always got the extra. Now put a little bit more of a smoked olives on here, just a little bit. And you guys, from now on, when I start cooking, I'm going to go ahead and put the directions to the food that I prepared the recipe is going to be in descriptions in all the products or whatever, you know, that I use my meat. So with that being said, put that back up. I'm going to preheat the oven to 375. That's a new stove, y'all. So y'all got to grill me. I just got it yesterday. Okay. We're going to bake 375. We're going to do this for 45 minutes. So, let me go ahead and wash my hands. Some of this seasoning off. And I'm going to go ahead and cut up onions. And I like to take my onions and put it on top of the meat. A lot of people like to use a lot of onion powder, but me, I'm just going to basically use an onion and put it on top of the meat and put it another foil on and stick it in the soap for 45 minutes. And once that's out, you know, done, then I'll take it out and
you know, and I'll go ahead and put my baby back barbecue sauce on. But you guys about to see me do the doggone thing. We're gonna make this stuff good. So while the oven is preheating right now, I'm gonna get me an onion. Oh, sweet Jesus, Lord have mercy. And my choice of vegetables that I'm gonna cook with the barbecue pork chops are gonna be cream style corn and spinach. And I'm gonna cook the boyfriend some lima beans. Yeah. He wants some lima beans. The boy love him some beans. But anyway, I already have a half onion that's already it's been cut. So only thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and wash it and go ahead and cut and put it on top of the meat. Always wash your vegetables, y'all. I can't stress that enough. And I don't know if you guys know something. They got in this area, they had a recall on cucumbers, saying that, you know, something was wrong with them. And they said about, I guess they said listeria. I don't know what it was, but I knew right then and there I wasn't going to buy no cucumbers until it was safe for me to do so. So right now, guys, I'm getting a knife to cut up my onion. And you can cut your onions how you want. Me, I like to cut mine kind of a dice the onions up and sprinkle on top of it. But just for today's recipe, I'm going to cut them in maybe a little bit thicker, because all I want this onions to do is just to season the meat. And of course, Ronnie, he likes grilled onions, so he might just tear these onions up. Any kind of onion would do. I'm going to show you guys what the pan looks like. I'm just going to put this back up. So this onion, ooh. And one thing, I hate cutting onions. Oh my God, they make you cry. They will make you cry. And I heard a lot of people say, well, put a needle in your mouth to, I don't know. You know how people have come up their own ways or whatever to deal with certain things in the kitchen. But definitely I've heard my grandmother and many elders that I know say, put a needle in your mouth and it keeps you from crying. You guys ever heard that before? And another thing, you can tell me on the playback or even in the comments section, do you guys like your pork chop with the bone in it or without the bone? Me, I like the bone in it. So what I'm doing now, guys, after I wash my onions, is I'm going to chop it up. I wish I could get close to you guys. So you ever see my onion? I'm just going to chop this. See, I'm going to build a camera. But right now, we're going to make it work. I'm going to chop this onion up, y'all. And I'm going to put it on top of the pork chops. I'm going to let you see it before I put it in there. All right. Chopping them up as fine as I can, as quickly as I can. So we can get this stuff inside the oven. Not to sit down for a minute. I think I'm catching a cold, y'all. And the reason for that is because I be on the air conditioner and then the power goes out when all these thunderstorms we got coming down here in North Carolina, South Carolina, state line, and honey. Woo! I tell you, now I done picked up a little slight little head cold. But that's okay because you know what? I got the night coil in the back, baby. And vitamin C to take with it, too. Auntie Mama always said, Stacey, you need to get you some onion soup. I remember when I got real sick, guys. I had pneumonia about 2 years ago. You guys know I was in and out of the hospital that year. Car accident, to doggone pneumonia. You know, I thank God that I'm here because, you know, I could have, little Stacey Little, or AKA Carolina Diamond, she could have been gone. I thank God every moment that I'm here because I'm telling y'all, I had broken ribs and some of everything, all because of missing a doggone deer. And I'm telling you something, y'all might think I'm telling a story. You have got to be extra careful too with deers. Deers are at its peak right now. You know, young bucks coming out there and they thriving and trying to get that 5-point rack out their head and trying to mate with these little dogs. Boy, they be everywhere. And then when they mate, boy, they just mate, mate, mate. They cut down all the trees down and they ain't got anywhere to go. So, of course, you know that they're going to just basically be here in this area. Just multiplying like rabbits. Oh my God. And then South Carolina says, you know, that they were going to allow sharpshooters to come in and, you know, exterminate the deers. I'll show you guys what this meat looks like. This is what it looks like. If I have to hold this laptop, can y'all see that? So, what I'm going to do now, y'all, is something totally different. Some of you guys may do this and some of you guys may not. I'm going to get a little bit of water and pour the corners. And what it's going to do is going to give it some steam and allow more of the flavor to come out. You know what I'm saying? Like that smoke flavor. It's going to be, oh God, it smells so good. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Just a little bit. You don't want to put a whole lot in there. You just want a little bit just to activate that olive oil to keep that meat nice and tender. Come out the bone real easy. So I'm just putting a little bit of water inside the corners. That's all. And then after doing that, I'm going to put extra coat on top. Barbecue hickory seasoning. Just a little bit. Just to bring the flavor out. And then that's what I want. And then what I'm going to do next, I'm going to go ahead and put another aluminum foil over the ceiling. I'm going to put it inside the... it's not in here. Oh, my God. Here we go. Just going to put a little bit more extra seasoning on top. Boy, that's going to be so good. Boy, it's smelling good right now, y'all. Y'all hear me? Oh, my God. Ooh, that seasoning smells mighty fine, mighty fine. A little bit more black pepper on top of it. And the oven is now hooked. It's 375 already. Awesome. Now y'all got two fans up in the kitchen, because I'm telling you right now, down here in the country, it's like 92 degrees. It gets a little smoky up in here, steamy up in here trying to cook. So that's why I waited to about, and it's almost 9, it's 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock. It's my eyes are seeping, so we got to go ahead and get this thing done. So what I'm going to do now, guys, I'm going to show you exactly what's going on. And I'm going to go ahead and put the... Can you guys see that? Lord Jesus, take the Lord. Okay, let's see if I can do this without making a mess. You guys can see that a little bit? I'm going to stick that in the oven. You see the little water and all the onions and the olive oil coming together with the seasoning? Man, it's slamming. I got 4 people in the building, 9 people in the chat. So what I'm going to do now, right now, just go ahead and put a little bit of aluminum foil on top. And what I want to do is go ahead and seal it where the steam, where the aluminum foil is covering the pan. And then you can see, make sure that it seals the meat so it can come out nice and tender. There we go. And go ahead and stick this inside of the oven for about 45 minutes. Then I'll take it out, add the maybe back real barbecue sauce to it, honey. And just guess what? It'll be time for dinner. So what I'm going to do right now, guys, I'm going to go ahead and put some of the stuff back up that I took out. And I'm going to get me some water. I'm going to sit down for a minute because I'm a little hydrated. I think I just need to try to hydrate myself and I'll feel a little bit better. So get a little bit of ice going here. I better take out my back. This is the barbecue sauce that I'm using, y'all. And I know you guys know. Yeah, this is pretty much the bacon. I'm going to use Ray's sweet smoky barbecue sauce. I did have baby back, but I don't have any, so we're going to use Ray's tonight. So I'm going to put this over here. And I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. I thank you guys so much for bombarding me in the chat like that. If I thought I wasn't going to see for a while, I saw y'all tonight. Y'all definitely made my Monday a magical, marvelous Monday. Thank you so much. Y'all know I love each and every one of you guys. And if y'all ever need anything from me, don't hesitate, honey. If it's humanly possible, I'll be there. Just call my name and I will be there, honey. So right now what I'm doing is y'all can get me some ice water, sit down, enjoy the chat, because we got to wait about 45 minutes until the meat is actually done. So about 25 minutes from now, I'm going to put on my vegetables, which my choice is going to be lima beans, and I think I'm just probably going to cook kuna. That's it. Oh, Lordy. Yep, the oven is now heated to 375, so we got to wait 45 minutes. And y'all, I tell you, it smells so good. And I got so many fans in here, it's just knocking down my towel. So I'm going to put this to the side over here, get my water. Some cold water. I'm sitting on top of y'all. I'm gonna get them wash these dishes. Yeah, but I take that back. I'm gonna get me some Diet Mountain Dew. But last night, yeah, we had a ball. I went to bed going out that live stream about 3:30 in the morning. Oh my God, my grandson and my daughter had already left and went back, and I was like, man, I said I gotta get up and see Auntie Mama. When I got up, honey, Auntie Mama had already went live and. She had already did her thing, and I was already like, oh my God, I need my coffee, Jesus. But I did make it to our live stream. I've seen a couple of you guys that went to Tuber Chat. He's doing great and marvelous things, and see a couple of the new up and coming YouTubers. And I was glad to, you know, sit down and watch some of this stuff. Some of these young YouTubers, they got some gorgeous stuff, man. They coming up with some great and marvelous things. So I'm gonna cut these lights off a little bit, y'all, because I'm gonna get up in a minute and wash my dishes. But I'm just trying to make it a little cool in here. Yes. Yes, Lord.
Wow. And I'll tell you another thing, you guys, I shouldn't have done. I had a big old piece of cake. Oh, man, it was so good. All that frosting on it, man, I just could not help myself. Y'all got to look at this chat. I got all these pop-ups coming up, so y'all got to excuse me, forgive me. Let me fix this fan. Man, the degree temperature, it's been hot, man. What was the temperature where you guys at? Whew, Jesus, thank you, Lord, for the fan. Mm. Thank you, Lord. Six people in the building, 9 thumbs up. And let's go back up and see where I stopped at last time. Okay, Buying Space Monday Night Meal Callers Live. Y'all, as the notifications come in, I'll let you know who's live. You got somewhere to go. Half the cake. Oh, Auntie Mama, you want to see it? You guys want to see my cake? No, I didn't eat half the cake. I ate about a portion like this, but I'm going to show you guys. Let me take the top off because I'm not going to finish the rest. My family's going to finish the rest because I'm telling you. I mean, that's the reason why I'm feeling bad because I've been eating junk food ever since yesterday on my birthday. Okay. Here we go, guys. I'm going to adjust it where you guys can see. Y'all can see all the flowers and stuff in the background and all of that and the balloons and the cake that I didn't eat that much of. It's happy birthday. Can you guys see it? Happy birthday, Stacy. And I only ate this amount in the corner right here. I'm trying to point because I got my laptop in my hand. Right up in here. Oh, wow, Auntie Mama. Ooh, you talking about something was so good, and then all of a sudden, when I was trying to go live earlier, guess what? Bam, the power went out, and it got hot up in here, and I started sweating and sweating and sweating, and I tell you, I was like, I don't feel good. I feel like I was about to pass out, and come to find out, the only thing I was having, I was high on sugar, because, you know, you guys know I love cake, but I'll eat cake as much as I have since I don't drop about 10 pounds. I've just been dedicated in the gym, guys, because I had got to the point where, you know, I won't say that I was eating a whole lot of foods, but, you know, as you get older in age, and I would say pre-menopause, you start gaining weight that you never thought that you'd do. So you have to switch things over so you can remain, so you can, you know, try to do the doggone thing and stay slim like you was when you were younger. And that's what I'm doing, y'all. I tell you what, by August, by Labor Day, y'all will call me little old Stacy Little. See, I can't give me another one of them bodybuilders. I'm not gonna be like real bulky, but cut up. Fabulously cut up. Y'all, let me put the top back on that cake. But I tell you what, though, I'm gonna probably give me another piece before I go to bed. Now after that, I gotta leave that cake alone, y'all. Because the reason why I say that is because I went to the doctor, to the Veterans Affairs Office. You know, that's where it's retiring service members and people that's been in the military go. And they did some blood work on it. I know it was like, everything is good. I ain't worried about nothing. So the doctor says, well, you want the good news or you want the bad news? I was like, well, give me the bad news. He said, no, I'm going to give you the good news. Good news, your blood work and everything is good. You are good health. But the bad news is this. You got some warning flags. I said, what is it? Well, yeah, Miss Little, you guys probably see Roberson on some of my stuff. And that's because I used to be married to another from Illinois, Chicago, named Roberson. So I'm Stacy Lee Little Roberson. But when I got divorced, I kept my name because of military duties. But long story short was, he said, Stacy, honey, your blood pressure is good, but you are pre, oh Lord, the words won't come on my tongue, y'all. Y'all know y'all don't claim it like that. You just give it to God and say, hey, I'm gonna get myself back right. Pre-diabetic range. And I was like, what? I wasn't born with it. I knew what I was saying because he was saying type 2. Pre means you need to cut back on the sugars, get your tail out the moving, and start doing something. So, honey, when I did that, I did start exercising, going to the gym, eating right. And, you know, basically, the only thing you want to do is keep the carb levels at a minimum. You know, don't eat a lot of sugar and all that stuff. You guys know what pre-dep that was. But me, I never thought that I could get like that, and I did. So, I started getting sugar out of my diet. I started listening to people like Auntie Mama and everybody else that goes to diet fad. I was like, start researching. I was like, man, I got to get this thing because I'm going to be diabetic. And the first thing I thought about was when my aunt passed away, because she raised me. She was diabetic and she got her legs amputated, but she was type 1, but she had to take insulin. First thing I thought about, you know, mom always said, promise me, don't you ever, ever, ever not work out or take care of your body. Well, it made me thought about that, and it made me say, hey, I'm going to do this. And then I started walking and, you know, getting up and doing what I was supposed to do instead of laying around and watching TV. And I got up and got to moving, doing things. And I went back and took the blood work. To God be the glory. I'm back in range, so I want to keep that motion going by keeping away from those sweet things. And yes, it's doggone true. You know, when we're young, we always think that we're going to eat whatever we want. Eat our Burger King, McDonald's, you want. And that is my biggest pet peeve. I love Big Macs. And that's what I was eating all the time. Go give me a Big Mac. Big Mac, Big Mac, Big Mac, Big Mac. Well, guess what? I had to trade in my Big Mac coupon for Subway and for the grocery store and learn how to cook my own food. Long story short, and that is it, y'all. That scared the dickens out of me. And I'll tell you another thing that really scared me, and the doctor says this. He said, the reason why your blood pressure is up because of what you're doing. I said, what do you mean what I'm doing? I'm working out, whatever. He said, now you are, but you know what? Your biggest thing is this thing called smoking. Yep. I'm guilty. But I got this nicotine gum. And for you guys who don't know, it's using nicotine gum. I'm going to read the chat, y'all. But the thing about the nicotine gum is people like to take the gum and chew it like it's chewing gum. And my doctor told me, he said, look, you don't chew the gum. You bite it, put it on your tongue, and boom. Well, guess what I did today? So proud of myself. Yes, guys, last night I had two left in the other pack or whatever. But what I did was I got the gum. I used it. Now, I had my uncle and my sister to try it, and they spit it out. And, of course, I tried it out, and I was like, I can do this. But after a while watching them, I was like, maybe I'll try it another day. But so today after I got home, after me and mom came back from the hairdresser and I left my sister, I tried it. And for about 5, 6, 7, however long it was, I didn't crave a cigarette. So guess what? Tomorrow, I had said that I think Wednesday was going to be my quit day. Tomorrow's going to be my actual quit day. So I'm going to come online. You probably see me around or whatever. You guys, like, pray for me because I know it's like I have withdrawal symptoms, all that. But I say this. If you want to live, make no excuses for it. Make none. Tomorrow I'm going to do my best praying, meditation. Y'all pray for me because, sister girl, I tell you, them cigarettes be calling my name. I'm going to have one. But I tell you what, I am proud of myself because I know one thing. I used to smoke a pack a day. Now it took me about a week to smoke a whole pack. So, like, right now when I'm sitting around and I might want to drink some cold water or whatever, I might want a cigarette. But what I've done is that I try to keep busy, and not do that. And I'm losing my check. I got 2 people building 9 thumbs up. I thank you guys so much for coming in. I'm just so overwhelmed that you guys are here, and I'm just so happy to see people I haven't seen from AAP down to, all of you, just all of y'all. I'm not just going to call it because you guys are so wonderful. And Deborah, my fellow military personnel, she's a Marine, I am Army. I miss you so much. And I just want to say shout out to all of you guys, because in some way, some form, y'all taught me something and y'all been my mentors. Y'all don't even know it. But I just want to tell you guys, I appreciate you and I love each and every one of you. I do with all my soul, all my heart, all my godly love. I love you. Now, y'all, I'm going to read the chat. Do y'all have any questions for me before I go back up? Well, can I just start right here? Auntie Mama says, have the cake. Yeah, and then Deborah Cabasa, home living, said here in Connecticut, 96 degrees. Oh, my God, honey. Auntie Mama, I think right now it's 84 right here. That's what I'm looking at. It was that Indian Trail I'm looking at. Well, anyway, it's finally cooling down. But tomorrow, they said today is the coolest day. But tomorrow, we're supposed to get a whole lot of rain, y'all, for the next so many days because of, was it Tropical Depression Beryl? Used to be a hurricane. And I was praying for Texas, and I was praying for Miami. I was praying for all of it. It was coming out, you know, of the ocean and hitting hidden land or whatever. But, you know, it is good to say that it has finally been downgraded. But I heard the weatherman on Channel 9 News say that it could upgrade, but chances are it won't. So I was glad to hear that because, you know, when a tornado, not a tornado, but a hurricane is out in ocean like that and gains strength, it has the capacity to get stronger. And I'm just so glad that it is weakening and there is not so much. I haven't seen the aftermath of what happened in Texas and all that, but I just pray that everyone stays safe and that, you know, prayers go out and, you know, just pray that everybody is okay. I do. And you know what? I'm a softy. When I see something that's very sad, I'm crying. You know, if I can do something about it, I'm going to do something about it. But anyway, getting back to the chat, I'm always begging, Deborah says. Auntie Mama says, okay. Digger, what's going on, Dirt Diggers UK, baby? It's 2 a.m. in the morning in the UK. I come from a land down under. You know I love the UK because you know why? Running eggs and y'all accent, the queen. I just love the UK. It's a beautiful place. I love it. I definitely love the way you guys accent when y'all talk. Eat some tea, drink tea with the queen. And those soldiers. Oh, man, those UK soldiers are awesome. Girl, I started working hard. Really? That's what's up. Deborah showing flowers and love. And Rhoda, what's going on, my friend? Man, I've been live 51 minutes and 20 seconds. It don't even seem like it. It don't. I don't know where this strength and while all this extra energy coming from. Because I'm telling you, about an hour ago, I was sitting here like, oh, Lord, I don't feel good. I didn't know if I needed to go to the emergency room and get my tilt checked or what. But I realized, you know, if I got cooled down, I probably got too hot and, you know, not drinking enough water and all that sugar inside your body just makes you feel down. And then my cake finally started digesting. I started getting more water and the air came on. I started feeling better. And then I seen y'all beautiful people. I saw y'all wonderful. I love you so much. Beautiful family members coming up in here. And it made me feel good. I was like, you know what? I'm going to go live. I didn't want to go out, so I'm going to go live. I'm going to cook. No matter how hot it is, we're going to do this. And I got the fan, and that's what I did, and I'm so glad. 4 people in the building, 9 thumbs up. If you guys have a video or premiere and you're in the blue, drop your links. If you're new to the channel, welcome. And if you like this content, go tell a friend, grab a friend, tell them about me, CDP. Some of you guys like to call me Carolina Diamond Ducks, CDP. CDP, come on and visit me because take CDP and I'm doing them to show love with you. And you know what we're going to do? We're going to network and get you through YouTube. I can't make that rhyme, y'all. I cannot make that rhyme. And yeah, it's turning out to be an okay day. It is. And guys, I'm going to tell you, know, I was a little bit upset. Not about the numbers. Because I see right now, thank God I'm 901. But I had to tell myself this. I had to pray because Auntie Mama, I told her at first, she's like, don't worry about numbers. Of course, you know, you're going to say, okay, I am worried about numbers because I am not. But I had worked like, oh my God. I guess I got, you know, when you first become a young YouTuber, when you first come on, you're so excited. I was so excited to be back until I just started boom, 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 going live. And I started working with BBQ and I'm like, you know, I can do this. And the little numbers just get up there or whatever. So I started doing that. And then I said, oh my God. And then my sister and my daughter said, Mom, you at 917. I was like, oh, you know, just so excited. And knowing experience with YouTube, that numbers do not mean a thing. Because one minute they're there and then next minute they're not. I got so excited and I was like, yeah, baby, I'm gonna have you. You know, just that little thing, them numbers do something to you. I don't know. This is a psychological thing we all YouTubers go through. But long story short was this. I stayed up to 3:30 in the morning, honey. Supposed to be Auntie Mama at 5:30 because I said, yeah, I told OG Brand, we're gonna be at Auntie Mama. Honey, I looked on that chair, laid on that chair, and I was just enjoying myself and just tired of a lot. I must have did like 6 or 7 live streams. I don't know. I was like, yeah, I'm back. Yeah, I'm going to be bona fide like all of y'all. I'm going to be subscribed. I'm going to be have my subscribers. I'm going to be monetized. Got up this morning. Lauren Cloud went. I was like, oh, my God. I got to get on Auntie Mama.
And so I looked at my thing, it says 899. It was 8 something. I think it was 884, whatever the case may be. Auntie Mama says, honey, don't you worry about them numbers. You know, you'll get it, you'll get it, you'll get it. And you know what? Auntie Mama had to pull me in, like, girl, you know what? Don't worry about it. It's gonna be all right. And I knew that. But the thing about it, they kept saying, you look how hard you work. Look how hard you work. And guess what? Don't nobody care. Because if they care, you would have been 1,000. I said, devil, you is a lie. I said, you is a dirty lie. I said, it ain't about the numbers, it's about love. So Auntie Mama started pepping me up, and I start pepping myself up, and I start feeling better. Then I come back on, y'all, it's 901. I said, it don't matter. It's all about love. It's all about friendship. All about people. They care about you. Y'all know I'm going to get emotional when I'm very, what's the word I want to say, when I have passion and love for people. AAP, Auntie Mama, Abandoned Boys. I remember 2 years ago, I would get on here, and God knows I don't drink anymore. I quit alcohol. When I would get on here and do the most craziest things, you got stuck with me, you know? It seems like I'm just a wild child back then, you know? And I look at where God brought me from and how God sent people to mold you. Even though I'm retired, sergeant major, and all that, but I look at how God sent angels to come for you. When you think that you're on top, God showed you something better. And that's what all of you guys have done in your own unique way. And I'm telling you guys, when I took my break to go, went to finish my college degree, I didn't tell them. I just like stop. And all these like, Carolina Diamond, where you at? People want to know where you at. Where you at? I was like, what? You know? And all the love that you guys had for me to reel me back in, like, hey, you know, even though you may be going to tell somebody, well, yeah, we love you. We love you. We care about you. And just to see that right there, man, it really, really touched me. And I tell you, one time I didn't stop by. I mean, I no matter what I would do, I would always keep my ears and eyes on YouTube and all y'all beautiful people. And I may not say anything sometimes. Sometimes I'll just come in and be like, hey, man, that's a wonderful thing they're doing. And, you know, and then time passes by. Like, I'll comment tomorrow, but I never did. And it's just amazing how your messages and your love and all the little comments I would read. You know, where you at, people be looking for you, Jacob. I just thank you guys so much. I'm sorry, guys. I don't mean to get teary-eyed, but these are tears of joy. And I just want to say thank you guys so much. Tuba Chad, oh, my God. I can name all. It's too many to name. I just want to say, guys, I love you so much. That's what I wanted to say. I had to take my glasses off to get these tears of joy just, like, over. Just on my face, and I love you guys so much. But anyway, y'all, that pork chops is smelling so good. Let me put my glasses back on so I can read the chat. I love you guys. I do. I love y'all so much. And y'all, the top ones, y'all know who y'all are. The ones that deal with me all the time. Like, girl, get your head out your butt. Do this, do that. God loves you. We here for you. We love you. And it just made me feel so good. Anyway, I had to share that with you guys, you know, that I've been meaning just thinking about, should I just do a live? And you know what? God said, say it now. Tell them how grateful you are and what kind of great friends they are, because you guys have been truly, truly instrumental in my growth as a YouTuber. And I love you guys so much. But anyway, let me stop being a boo-hoo and all these tears. I'm like, girl, come on now. We don't need all of that. But I just want to say thank you. And Deborah Case is showing love. Rhoda Orland, she's throwing a heart. And Brian G100, what's going on, my friend? I'm at a point at my YouTube journey that numbers and monetization ain't a thing to me no more. Ain't that the truth, baby? Because I'm going to tell you right now, my passion ain't about making no money on YouTube. My passion is loving and networking and making family members and friends that last forever with y'all. Now, that alone is priceless. Priceless. And sit down and talking about God and how good God has been to us and just showing up and showing out, because you know God's gonna make everything all right. To God be the glory. But thank God for the angels like y'all that he's seeing to help me along the way. And in return, we help each other. We become a family of God on YouTube. Now, how powerful is it?
Money can never replace that, baby, honey. Priceless. Amen. Woo, that feels so good. Y'all gonna get the Holy Ghost up here. Y'all know, to God be the glory, y'all. I don't care. Me and Miles, we serve God. I would tell you, without him, we wouldn't be here. God make the possible. He makes everything. He make the possible out of impossible. You know what I'm saying? Oh, let me quit preaching there. But anyway, reading the chat. I feel so much better, y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for listening. Thank y'all for being here for me. And in return, y'all know y'all get that big love from me. And thank you for all the beautiful birthday. Hey, Alberta and Stella, what's going on, you honey? What's going on? I know I done got symptoms. I forgot where I was in the chat somewhere. I'm at the point in my life, YouTube journey, the numbers, that numbers and monetization ain't a thing to me anymore. You know what? It should never be a thing to me. I mean, at first it was a thing to me, but it's not. Even though, you know, you'd be like, okay, I'm going to get some cheeseburger money, honey, one day. But you know what? That's not the most important thing. It's love and the friendship and the journey that you have along the way. That's what it is for me. Everybody got their own thing that makes them why they do YouTube. But me, I just love good people and just good friendship and sit down and, you know, we just connect and just make everything beautiful by sharing the word of God. Not just talking about it, but being about it, you know. But anyway, getting back to the chat. Well, won't he do it? Yes, he will. Answer mama, to God be the glory. Yes, he will every time, honey. I can't tell you how many times God has brought me out of danger and harmful things that could have just took me out. From a bullet to desert storm to the accident to when I had no more. To God be the glory, honey. We all got our testimony. We sure do. And I thank you, Jesus, for keeping me here so I can have one. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say they know Jesus, but do you have a personal relationship with him? I know I do. If he about did the same thing for me, he'd do the same thing for you. Y'all, let me get my cord because I want my battery to die on me.
My laptop. But Auntie Mom, I am so glad that Uncle Daddy is doing well. Hopefully he'll be coming home soon. I really hope so. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Y'all, I didn't mean to get sentimental on you, but sometimes you gotta do what the Lord says, thus the will of God. You get emotional, let it out. It ain't about the Holy Ghost freaking on you, honey. Yes, Jesus. Boy, I tell you, them pork chops are smelling divine.
Yes, Lord. They're going to miss the cheese mouth. Lord, yes, it is.
Yes.
But anyway, y'all, we've been on 1 hour and 2 minutes. Hallelujah. Oh, man, I feel so great.
I just finished dinner. Sorry, I'm late. I brought this up, baby. You ain't late. Well, I basically did. Just took the pork chops. You know, season them on both sides, put a little olive oil on the side of the pan, flip them around, put them in there, throw some onions, all the good seasoning, however you want to season them up, seal them up with some aluminum foil, throw them in for about 45 minutes, and we're going to turn around, boom, put some baby back on them and enjoy them. They smell so good. I was going to cook them in the Instant Pot, but I was like, I like the Instant Pot for what it does. It makes your food good and it's not hot, but honey, if I had to choose between the pot and the stove, baking, I'm baking. That's when I can't stand the kitchen when it gets too hot. But let me read the chat, though. Alberta says, hey, girl. Hey, honey. Auntie Mama says, amen, queen. Amen, Auntie Mama. I just finished dinner. Sorry. I'm like, what did you cook, Alberta and Stella? God kept me sane through foster care. Amen. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Alberta, so I know your testimony, baby, because you definitely have one. And I sit there, honey, I will shout with you. Thank God for you, honey, because I know we all been through different paths, different walks, you know. And a lot of people say, well, I understand you. We can't understand what you're going through. We can sympathize because don't nobody know how to walk in your shoes and you don't know how to walk in mine. But we can get together and say, thank you, Lord, for giving us the path to walk and getting through. You feel me? Hi, Auntie Mama. Good to see you. Alberta and Stella saying, Auntie Mama, we just had our roast beef dinner with our Instant Pot. What? Oh, Alberta, you got to share some recipes. You want Auntie Mama with me?
Boom, honey. We can collaborate some things. Yes, Lord. Auntie Mama, I get up my car, I drive to Charlotte and just sit down with her on there and just eat, eat, eat. Yes, honey. Yeah, I got that Instapot. I got the Instapot, but I realized that 4 or 5 different Instapots. And I'm looking for recipes. I'm like, wait a minute, that's not the duo. And then they got one small 10 ounce and these big ones. Oh my God. And the Instapot, they are so fun, but I got to find the recipe. When I bought this one, they didn't have no recipe book to it. So I'd be looking on YouTube. And I hear Auntie Mama says she got an Instapot. And hey, I just want to be an Instapot queen chef. Yes, yes, yes. I just got to get used to it, though. We do our roast beef with some coffee and herbs, potatoes, and man, it does it less than 90 minutes. You will have it fall apart. Yeah, I've seen it because I remember the first time Auntie Mom was here. Auntie Mom was with me. Love her so much. And she told me she had Instapot. I was cooking. What was I cooking, Auntie Mom? Some kind of meat that felt chicken, drumsticks, chicken, was it? Ribs, drumstick, one or the other. And I cooked them twice, and then I cooked some neck bones. We don't eat no bones for my mom who wanted to use it. So we sat there and she showed me how to do it. And I was like, you know, it smelled good because I like to take the juice from the neck bones. I don't eat the meat, but I like the juice when she makes it. Put a little bit on my rice and it just tastes so divine. And once she hooked it up. But anyway, I'm learning how to cook. And the next thing I want to know how to do is how to grill. I can cook in the kitchen, but when it comes to that grill, I'm like, I can keep that. But anyway, just saying. We do our, okay. Auntie Mama says, hello, Ed, Alberta and Stella. And Alberta and Stella says, look on Temu. They have Instapot guy on Amazon and on Temu. What about them little pots, though? They said, I seen on some of the videos on YouTube where they can cook the meat and then they cook the rice and then something else and all three of them. You know what? I feel like this. Until I get a mastery at that, what I'm going to plan on doing my Instapot, what's up, Rhoda, baby? What I plan on doing is cook my meat separate, and I put my vegetable stuff in the pot and cook it that way, or cook it in my other slow cooker. I'm serious. I mean, because I'm like, you need an Instapot to cook some rice? But they said that rice be turning up, be the bomb. You ain't got to worry about washing starch off or none of that stuff. I don't know. It's like me. I know how to cook rice on a pot on the stove, but why go get a rice maker when you know how to cook rice on the stove? I mean, it's just, you know, I'm just, you know, becoming open to other ways to cook. How about that? Yes. Yep, the roast beef. I bet it was. It sounded like it was good. Auntie Mama, what were some of the things that you cook? I know you bring, honey. Auntie Mama can make anything happen in the kitchen. She is just so good. I was going to ask her, what did she cook? In her Instapot, she told me one time. But then again, there's other people that use Instapot. They get intimidated because it's a computer thing. But the thing is that you got to get used to using your Instapot, is what I hear. And so I've been using it. But tonight, I said, I ain't messing with that thing. John Paul is live, y'all. He's doing watch dog too. I guess he's playing the game. But yep, we do our roast beef and potatoes in our Instapot. Are you going to make a recipe or cook on Instapot? Cook your Instapot on, excuse me, YouTube. That'd be cool. And Miss AAP, AAP, are you still in the building? I know you probably got there early, or maybe you got other things to do. I know all your content creators probably got things to do. And I know you got a life outside of YouTube. And I just thank you for being here. But I was just wondering, does Miss AAP or any other, anybody else in here, if you use the Instapot, you know, just let me know so I can come through and be like, give me some recipes. And I'll be like, yeah. You know, give you a shot. Like, I got this recipe for Auntie Mom or Stella, Alberta and Stella, and boom, I'm learning how to cook this thing. Boom. You know? Or we can just do a cook-off or something. Because that is going to be my next project. You know, I looked at the life of a soldier, all these things people want me to do. But what I want to do, I want to come just cook. Just cook. Just cook, Instapot, cook, whatever. Just cook. And then we have some fun that way. Y'all won't get mad at me because I'm going to smoke this cigarette right now. I'll do push-ups later, but I'm going to smoke this cigarette. Somebody told me you can't smoke on YouTube. Is that right? If that's the case, then guess what? I won't be smoking at all. I'll be going back there. But I don't want to leave my chat because that's another thing. You know, when I was live streaming a lot and a lot of things were going on over the last 2 weeks that, you know, I don't sit down and I noticed I didn't like that. You know, I'm in and out, trying to get the watch time out or whatever. So I say, you know what? No, we're not going to do that anymore. What we're going to do is going to be here with our chat, with our people, let them know that we care. And if I want to get watch time hours a night, I'll just be like, hey, watch time, hours, or, you know, put it in a better perspective. You know what I'm saying? It's up and leaving to come back. I think that's kind of rude when I saw my, when I was editing myself. And then, you know, some of the times I am guilty. I mean, you guys probably are too. Some of you guys are maybe not. But this is the thing for me, is that when I get done editing, when I get done with my live stream, I don't edit. I don't go back and look. And I know there's one or two videos out there that I am totally mute. I was like, oh my God, man, what was I thinking? So now I'm in the process of going back, editing my videos or whatever, even my live stream before I stick them out there. You know, because I want to give you guys good quality. Not like the past, something totally different, something totally new. Yeah, but read in the chat, will you make some salmon patty? Oh, yes, honey. Oh, what? Let me show you what I got up in this cabinet. Salmon patties is my favorite. And you talking about salmon patties, honey? They're always on deck. They are always on deck, baby. I love salmon patties. Matter of fact, my favorite meal, my mother would tell you, is salmon patties and tomatoes and rice. I call it tomatoes and rice. You might call it Spanish rice, but down around here in Chesterfield, Troward area, South Carolina, more of a North Carolina area, booyah, we call it tomatoes and rice, salmon patties. It got so bad. My mom said she gets so tired of cooking salmon patties when we were a kid. She used to play with us and say, them little snakes, and we thought we were going to quit. Mm-mm, honey. We know the difference between a salmon and snake, mom. Sorry, cannot do salmon of any kind, but tomato and rice, I so badly want to learn how to do it. Easy. Boil your rice, wash it off. My mother and I use, can't believe it's not butter now. Put two cans of diced tomatoes and boom, there you go. Too easy. But you know, everybody got their own different type of season. That's mine. Salt, pepper, diced tomatoes. And my secret ingredient is, I can't believe it's not butter. Auntie Mama might make hers differently, but that's the way I make mine. Miss AP may make her different. That's the way I make mine, though. But, you know, to each his own. And that's why I love asking people recipes, because my intention one day is to make my own cookbook. You know, I wrote books before, but cookbook has always been my passion. And I'm going to do it. Auntie Mama help on y'all's help. All of y'all up in here. Just give me some advice and just get to cooking. Finest Wine, I haven't seen him lately. I seen him do a video, but normally he usually drop in. But he has become such a, I don't know, he's cooking for famous people that I hardly ever get to see him. But I haven't seen him. I guess, I think I was live streaming. I don't know. And I was, and like I said, running in and out when I should have been sitting down. I would have noticed him. He was in the live stream. Okay, let me get back up to, we do our roast beef and potatoes. I'm sorry if I missed you guys' comment. Let me know. I'll go back up and read it again. You can also do a full chicken in the Instant Pot in less than 2 hours, and it falls off the bone. Okay, Albertus, I read that too. I seen a video about that. Just make sure to add about half a cup of water to every time, and you will have the meat beyond tender. Oh, yep. That's definitely true. Albertus Seller says, never follow recipes. We just do it the way we think, and it should be done. LOL. I think that's the best way to do it, baby. That's the best way to do it. And Jazz said, yes, make that. I will. I definitely will. I might do that tomorrow. Well, tomorrow. Yeah, I definitely will, because tomorrow, what I got going on tomorrow besides the gym? Absolutely nothing. You know, just come in and, you know, I'm sure these pork chops going to be going on the lickety-split. Everybody be like, oh, God, pork chops, give me some. That's everybody's favorite meal around here. It's going to be, and maybe around lunchtime or when nobody is going live, because I kind of try to take Tuesdays off to, you know, just be, you know, lounging in the YouTube streets, but not tomorrow. On the weekend, gotcha. Gotcha. And I'll make some then. Yeah. Sorry, can I do the salmon of any kind, but tomato rice, I so badly want to learn how to. It's pretty easy. Oh my God, hubby just told me to coast to get an oven. Let me see. Oh my God, hubby just told me the cost to get an oven installed is now almost $900 now. Oh, honey, I'll tell you how much I paid my oh my God. Yeah, they're pretty up there. Yeah, everything is getting high, honey. Not tomorrow, on the weekend. Did you have a good birthday? Yes, I did. Oh my God, Jazz. I had a wonderful birthday. And my problem with my birthday was is I ate too much sweets. Oh my goodness. I must have went crazy over some chocolate cake. I must have went crazy over all the popcorn and candy. And my grandson and I, we had a candy party watching Jack Harmon. Tootie Totter Totter and all that. I don't know if you know what Jack Harmon is, but it's a little guy, a guy who has his own YouTube channel dedicated for little kids or whatever. And we just tootie totted all around here. We had candy and playing games, and we just had a wonderful time. He turned my birthday party into his birthday party, and it was extra, extra special because he put Santa Claus hats on our heads and said, "It's Christmas, Grandma." I said, "You know what? Christmas in July. Let's get it." And we just had a good time till 1:30, 2:30 in the morning. Boom. Next thing I know, they was leaving. I was asleep on the chair. Oh, my God. It was the best birthday ever. And these so many birthday shout-outs. And I thank you guys so much, you know, because like I said, I must have answered about, I think I'm halfway done, probably about 300 or 400 different, you know, shout-outs. And I personally try to send messages, but some say I can't do all that. So I just put love, 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 love. Thank you. Love, love, love. On Facebook and, you know, whatever. But I think what I'm going to do instead of trying to go back and answer all it, because here's the 8th, about to turn the 9th. Today is my niece's birthday, my sister's daughter. But what I'm going to do is just put a message up, says thank you guys for all the birthday shout outs, blah, 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 blah. Thank you very much. Always a fun time from the sounds of it. Yes, yes, yes. Did you enjoy your cake? Yes, I did. I had a big old piece of it when I got home, and it kind of made me sick because I had a sugar high to it. And then the lights went off. Oh, my God, when it did that, I got hot. I could have got cold water, but I wasn't thinking about it because I'm like, yeah, the lights going to come on in a minute. And a minute and turn to 10 minutes, and 10 minutes and turn to 30 minutes, and boom, it was hot. So I had went outside, and my shirt that I had on was really wet. I had something on better on before I went live, before I came live, but I had to put this on. I had this shirt on when I went live, and then I had another shirt just like it. I put it back on. And I must have went like 3 shirts, man. I'm just saying, it was just that doggone hot. And then I was like, I'm not going to go live. And someone said, yes, you are. You need to go live. You need to go live. You'll feel better. And when I did, boom, God just showed up and showed out. And you guys came through. I've been happy ever since then. I think it might have been all that cake and all that heat, y'all. That's what that was. That meat smelling good. I think it's about 10 more minutes. I'm ready to take it out. You need a wireless rechargeable fan, girl. You know what? That is about right. But what I'm trying to do is, see, my central air gets it real cold in here. It does. It gets, since they don't fix the air the way it should be. And so, but what happened was, is that, you know, I was sitting here and going live. So I don't know if you guys are in the live stream. I know Auntie Mama asked me what happened, saying there was no sound, but lightning struck a transformer down the road here and everything just went out. Boom. And we got a next door neighbor over here. Got a little 2-year-old boy. She was like, oh my God. So I kept going over there, giving her some water, ice water, whatever, for her baby. And then everything, you know, came. And then all of a sudden the lights came back on. And, you know, we back up and running. But my thing was, I shouldn't have ate all that sugar. And I should have been drinking the water the whole time. See, this is my problem. I wasn't drinking water all day. I was drinking Diet Cokes and energy drinks all day. That was my problem. But boy, I tell you what, a hard head make a soft butt, won't it? I bet you tomorrow I'll start drinking water, lemon water, and definitely minimizing that doggone sugar stuff on it. Ooh, Lord. And then also, I forgot to tell you, the doctor said I had a vitamin D deficiency. I forgot. So you started putting me on vitamin D supplements, and, you know, I started feeling better, and whatever. And I guess, you know, my birthday, I didn't think to, you know, hydrate, because when you drink a lot of sugar, and you guys don't know, if you take ibuprofen or Tylenol, things of that nature, if you're not drinking enough adequate water, some of those things can make you even more dehydrated. I didn't know that until my doctor told me. I said, okay, gotta stay hydrated. And not only that, water is a good source, but my doctor wanted me to take Pedialyte, like you look at little kids, you need some Pedialyte in your life. And I started drinking Pedialyte, boy, I tell you, I'll go to the gym where I can run an extra mile or whatever. Like, yeah, you know, so I'm just happy, you know what I'm saying? They have a, you know, kind of shocked me with that pre-diabetic thing, but I'm glad, you know, after my results that he was like, you doing okay, but now you need to stay on it for a long haul. Let me see how good you're going to do for 6 months. I said, I can show you what I'm going to do. I can show you what I'm going to do. We're going to turn this whole thing around. I said, Jesus, you take the wheel. And that's how we're going to do it. And this cake thing, I'm going to let Ronnie and mom and sister and brother, they come and have this cake because birthday time is over. It's time to get back to the gym. Yes, Lord. Y'all see, I'm just holding this cigarette. Just holding it. I think I'm overcoming it, y'all. Might as well, because come Wednesday, ain't going to be no more of that smoking. And I was so motivated last night. I'm like, yeah, I can do this. I can. We can do anything we want to in life. You just got to know that you can be bigger than. I keep saying I'm bigger than this cigarette. But, you know, it's been scientifically proven that reason why so many people like to smoke is not the actual nicotine that they miss. It's doing something with your hands, you know? So they say. Yes, yes, yes. Was it a big cake? Yeah. Let me show you the cake again. Let me show you the cake again. Hold up. And then I'm going to check on this meat, y'all. Because I think it's about that time. Y'all like, share me out. Smash that like button. And I'm telling you right now, if you're in the blue and you got some content, please, 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 oh, please drop your links. Here we go. I mean, I'm about to take that thing off. We can take the cake lid off so you can actually see it. But I'll just show you because all it's going to say is, happy birthday, Stacy. And it got a two big balloons. Can you see? See that? And yep, it's come from Walmart. I love Walmart. My daughter bought this cake from Walmart. She was like, Mom, I forgot to get a cake. Do you want a cake? Because I told her I didn't want no sweets. I was like, nah. She's like, Mom, a birthday is not a birthday without a cake. So she went and got that cake from Walmart and, you know, did the doggone thing. And then we went out to Coach's and went to dinner and, you know, had planned on going to the beach, but it was just too hot. So, you know, we end up, you know, just sitting down and, you know, going to get dinner and just, you know, enjoying one another's company, you know, just like, you know, just staying cool. And, you know, not just for me, it was just basically to make sure my grandson, you know, he didn't get out there and get overheated. And my granddaughter is in Paris with her grandmother, so she's having a time. I was like, man, I wish I was with them, but at the same time, I know for me right now is not be a good time for me to go overseas, especially when I see Putin and Kim Jong-un sitting there, oh, Lord, reuniting with each other. I mean, you know, getting to know each other. Like, now, that's something you don't want to see. But anyway, let's not talk about politics. It is what it is, and let it do what it do. It was a real big cake. It was okay. It was a Walmart cake, and they, you know, put the icing on it, and it was nice. But it's just too much cake for me to eat alone. So I ate my piece, and, you know, I think, you know, one thing about it, it's good to treat yourself. But me, I've been indulging ever since the 4th of July every day, honestly. I mean, I go to the gym, don't get me wrong, but when it comes to being on my diet, I've been cutting up. So it's time to get back on track. Daniel Berry Sports Highlights is definitely live right now. Talking about Seager. I guess he's playing a game right now. And he was in my last live stream before, you know, all the lights went out from that doggone lightning strike. You know, Lord does his ways. I ain't going to say nothing much about him. I'm just saying that he was in my chat. And, you know, he's doing some great and marvelous things. So he's on that sports stuff. And he just getting to the point instead of showing the whole game. Like some people try to draw it out to get watch time out. He goes in right to the point. Yes, yes, yes. And Cruz Baller says, Alberta Stella, I like diamond painting too. Oh, I love diamond painting too. But you know what? You put a lot of effort in that, man. I seen, who was it? I'm subscribed. I can't remember her name. But she was doing some diamond painting. Boy, I tell you, it turned out to be some. She would do like whatever she, but it turned out to be so beautiful. I was like, go, girl. You do your thing. I don't have the patience to just sit there and do the numbers and that number. I'm like, oh my God, but you give me some cross stitching and me, I crocheting. I mean, I don't know how to do, but was Auntie Mama, I believe, was crocheting, and her and her one of her friends in her chat would tell her how to do a double loop, and I would learn how to do it, and you know, had a good time with it. Yes. Okay, good size cake. Cruz Bolero says Alberta and Stella Eye Diamond Paint too. You know what? Well, hold on now. You got some content. You know what? I just saw you today, baby. Yes, in Tuber Chat. So guess what? And I just left. Got some great. Yeah, you do have some great content because I went by your channel. I don't know who else is here, guys. I don't know. Like, share me out that, you know, is new. And I saw, but you know, as they come through, you know, two or three more times, boom, you know, they're gonna go ahead and get the blue. But Cruz Bolero, yeah, you got your blue. Because I done seen your channel a couple times, 3, 4, 5 times, and I'm just saying, you got some good content. And there was another young lady I saw today. Tuber Chat has some amazing people that he inspired. I mean, he inspired one of me when I first came. You know what I'm saying? And I would tell you guys, you know, God sent angels in different ways to help you do things that you never thought that you'd be able to accomplish. You know, you can't accomplish by your own. God would send somebody for you to be the path to show you the light. You know, especially trying to do something positive. But Tuber Chat and Running X, I would definitely say those guys have raised a lot of us to do things the right way, from the banner to the thumbnail. And you know what? And it's a beautiful thing that they take time out of their busy schedule just to show us these things, because, you know, they could be all about the numbers. I'm going to get the numbers for myself. I'm going to have more live streams and more people in mind. I ain't going to tell nobody nothing. But they're not like that. They're not like that. They're true leaders. You know, they come in and do their thing and just try to help people out. And I thank them so much. Alberta Stella, you know, you're a motivator. Cruz Bolero, you too. I mean, God, Auntie Mama, Jazz T, guys, I can keep going on and on and on. Everybody here got something to offer. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just so happy. Y'all, I'm going to check that meeting about 5 more minutes, y'all, because it is smelling good. I'm going to make sure it's okay. Yeah, somehow or another, I got so emotional that I lost contact with the chat. Because I'm telling you, God would touch you for a moment. You just get so grateful where you've been, where you come from, and where you're going. And God's got his hands on it. And he's sending beautiful people like y'all. You just get emotional. You just got to let the Lord show up and have his way. And boy, but somehow or another, I forgot my placement in the chat. So I didn't want to bore everybody by going back up, because myself was mute when I first started. So I said, I'll just grab a point and just keep rolling with it. Yep. Y'all, excuse me, I'm going to smoke this cigarette, and it's going to be my last one for the night, and tomorrow is Tuesday. I'm going to try not to smoke at all. Can't even light it. Yes, I'll tell you, though, but about 2 years ago, I was trying to quit, and so far, I had got down to the fact that I was like, yeah, I can do this. I can quit. Then my only downfall was this. I went and got a glass of wine and boom, started picking up again. Now I don't drink. I have no excuse. I just want to smoke it. Yeah, I guess I got a little urge, or what's the word I'm looking for to say without saying in Spanish, is that I just want to smoke it. Yeah. But anyway, y'all, I am having a wonderful time. Alberta Silla, we are human states. I know it. But you know, when I'm trying to set a goal for myself, and the goal is Wednesday, I'm like, why can't I quit now? But I know if I don't follow the guidelines, what my doctor set out for me, that I'll end up jumping back on the bandwagon trying to smoke again. So I'm just sitting here like trying to, you know, tell myself I really don't need the cigarette. And yet and still, I haven't lit it yet. It's just something in my hand. But maybe more push-ups or sit-ups or something, but I'm going to enjoy this one. I am. While we're sitting down waiting on the meat, it's 9:48. Oh, my God, it's about 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Dripping and dropping.
Excuse me, y'all. Put this hat up.
See, I don't even need it. I'm out to eat it too over. I want it so much, I want to eat it.
My boyfriend like, you don't need that stuff, Garrett. Put them cigarettes out. He don't smoke. He like hashtag 420. That's what he likes. Mm-hmm. But anyway, y'all, I'm having such a wonderful time. Yeah, in 5 minutes, y'all tell me, get up and go check on the meat. I'm trying to, you know, smells good. So I'm gonna get, in 5 minutes, I'm gonna get him to check on the meat. Thank you, bro. We are human. But somebody told me you can't smoke on YouTube. Is that right? I would hate to get over here and start smoking, but ain't said nothing yet, because I see a lot of people smoking, like John Paul, I Love to Death, and Mayhem Miracles, May, she smokers, and I seen Katie Roby, MFW. She ain't on TikTok anymore, not hardly, unless, you know, she do her little special appearance or whatever, Love to Death. But she smoked TikTok. She said TikTok you can't smoke on. But come to Wednesday, I'm gonna have my gun and I'm just gonna be doing my thing. I will go get it now. But I would think that maybe right now probably make me sick because I don't smoke a cigarette. That versus I have, let me see. I have smoked on YouTube with no issues. Me too. Remember, I just smoke like a train. But somebody told me recently that you're not supposed to smoke. Well, just like they said, you know, you say the word subscribe. You can say the word subscriber on your. They just don't want you to put it in the chat, type in the chat, because it causes a big old spam or something like that. And I was listening to somebody, I think you're in Tuber chat. He was interviewing somebody and says, I wish they would get rid of the word subscribe. And you put it down and tell us subscribe, but somebody typing in YouTube get mad. Brought a good point up. Let's check on this meat, y'all.
Sweet Jesus.
Oh. Hey,
oh, Lord.
What's cooking?
What's
cooking? No, I'm going to check on the meat with the barbecue sauce on when I'm ready to eat.
Me too, man.
Oh, God, it smells so good, y'all. Oh yeah. Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Okay, now I don't burn this stuff first. I need to get my mittens, but I got them, my cooking mittens in the dryer right now, so we're gonna go this old school. Alright. Don't burn myself. Oh yes. Stop the stove. I need a fork. I'm gonna wash my dishes next. I gotta put the barbecue sauce on it. Oh my goodness. Oh Lord, y'all. Y'all got to check it out.
Check it out. Check it out.
Okay, let me see if I get a little small little knife or something and cut it. Wash my dishes on the side of the sink, which I'm going to do next. Oh my God. Y'all, it is coming off the bone. Y'all hear me? When I tell you, I'm going to show you guys a sample of it. It is coming off the bone. I'm going to put my baby back barbecue sauce on. I'm gonna show you guys what it looked like. See, this is what it turns out. I'm gonna put the barbecue sauce on it. Melt in your mouth, man. It's slamming. So I can go ahead and put the barbecue sauce on it now, guys. And I'm gonna show you how I do that. Let's take the aluminum foil off. You guys do this. I'm just gonna put the barbecue sauce front and back, and then sit in there for about 5 more minutes. Then put another topping on, and it should be done. I can go ahead and cook my vegetables now. So, but you know, it's just been so hot, and normally I would be done cooked by now. I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like. But it's just been so hot, and the air conditioner finally got the house cooled down. I'm gonna do this part, and I'm gonna bring you guys over here so y'all can see what I'm doing. And basically, you know, a lot of people just put a little bit on the eye, like, to put all my barbecue sauce on top of my meat, front and back, so you can have an even film of barbecue sauce on it, you know, covering all portions of the pork chop itself. So I'm gonna do that part, little bit more on this one. I'm gonna show you guys what I'm doing and put it back in the stove. I'm gonna let it bake for 5 minutes on one side and bake for 5 minutes on the other. On a 425. My mother says, tell me at this point, she don't put her aluminum foil back on hers. But she like to have that grill taste on hers. But me, I like mine to just marinate with the oil and give it that extra flavor on the barbecue and the pork chop. I usually have my barbecue brush, but today I don't have it outside on the grill. Something I don't know, I do somebody else want to hold on. Let me show you guys what I'm doing. Hope you guys can hear me. I promise y'all, I'm gonna invest in me a good camera and a good phone. I'm good at a microphone where you guys can hear me as I'm cooking. I want to look professional when I do it. That barbecue sauce is slamming, though. Somebody bring it to you. Bring y'all over here. And y'all can see what it looks like.
And I'm gonna sit down and put it in the refrigerator. It's not the refrigerator. Oh my God, the refrigerator. Put it back in the stove and let it bake on top. Can you guys see that? Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna cover it back up for 5 more minutes and let it cook on the other side. You can be ready to eat, but I'm putting my vegetables on next. So I'm gonna cover this back up, you guys. Yes, I am. Put it back on like it was. Mm-hmm. Back in the phone. All right, I don't know what I'm trying to do. Alrighty, open the stove up. Put it back in. That's why I love to have my cooking mittens on. You gotta worry about burning yourself with them. I have too much quality and too much material on your hand. You can't see what you're doing. So I'm gonna let that stay in 5 moments. Sit this on to the side over here. Put my cooking cloth back up like they were. And about, I'm gonna give myself 5 more minutes. I'm gonna do my vegetables. Put them on. And then flip the other side of the pork chops and we should be done. Yep. And reason I would have been done cooking by now, guys. I really would have. But like I said, you know, the lights went out and meat wasn't unthawed and I was hot. And I was like, man, I ain't cooking. And I was thought about going out and get me fast. I was like, no, we're going to do this thing. We're going to eat right, live right, and you got to do right. Cook. So that's how that was. But getting back to the chat, we are human. I haven't smoked on YouTube with no issues. I have smoked on YouTube with no issues. I quit cigarettes over a year ago, but do vape now and then. Vaping, they tell me, is pretty good, though. I haven't tried that, but I have friends that do it, that love it. Old school works just as well. Don't eat pork myself, but looks good. Yeah, I don't eat it that much, but tonight I wanted something totally different because he likes chicken, baked chicken all the time. And I was like, I don't want no chicken. I'm getting me some baked pork chops. So I have pork chops every blue moon. But normally that I'd be like salmon, fish, you know, or maybe some, I don't know, other than pork. That's pretty much it. Ground beef. Yeah, ground beef type of person. I know that tastes good. It does. It does. Yes, we can hear you fine when you are over there by the sink. Okay. Have a good night getting ready to work. Cruz, have a good night. Thank you for coming, my friend. And anybody that left the chat and I didn't speak to, say goodnight. Blessings, blessings upon blessings. And I know it's 10 o'clock and some of y'all got to have, you know, lay it down or whatever. I understand. Thank you for stopping by, Cruz. And I definitely will be by your live stream and all you guys that's in the chat. I may not be there tonight, but I will be there. I'm coming. Coming. Definitely coming. But you have a wonderful, wonderful Tuesday. And I hope it was the best Tuesday ever for you, Cruz. Thank you. And welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You look good in your blue, honey. And the cigarette went out. So y'all tell me something good. I could tell you what, it's been a beautiful, blessed Monday. It really has. It really, really has. And I've been on here almost an hour and 39 minutes. And it does not seem like I've been that long. And I know, honey, I get emotional and it just had to come out. I'm just grateful. Having such great friends like you guys. Belated happy birthday, my friend Carolina. Thank you so much, Rhoda. Thank you, darling. Thank you so much. Does anybody have a birthday coming up this month or anniversary? I know we have a lot of August birthdays coming up. I was listening to Auntie Mama's chat. You got a birthday or something? Let me know, because I'd like to send you something special or do something special for you. I really would. But anyway, mine is on the 30th of this month. What? All right, Leo. Let me know, honey. I got you. Matter of fact, I'm going to write it down. Still, I knew yours is 30th of this month. I knew that. Yeah. Albert said, I knew that because I remember you telling me that. Because one time you was like, you was going to a football camp, training camp. What was it? I was like, do a live or something. You told me it was your birthday. So that's how I remember that. You'll be 56. Get out of here. Oh, my goodness. You sure don't look it. You sure don't look it. Seattle Seahawks. Yeah, I remember. Matthew Combs. I seen Matthew earlier, but Matthew's doing a lot of traveling. And I remember, yeah, and him and Jacob, I think, was in a live stream. Yeah. Advance, happy birthday to you in Alberta. And so, yes, definitely. Happy early birthday, baby. Early birthday shout out to you, baby. Yes, what are you planning on doing, Alberta, Stella, for your birthday? Well, me, I'll tell you what I'm planning on doing. Part two, because part one, my grandson, we loved the fact that we had a good time. But I intend on this weekend going to the park, Terrell State Park. And I just want to swim. Yes, Seahawks training camp is fun. My daughter's birthday is the 31st. Yes, I know, Auntie Mama. Oh, yeah. I know you and Uncle Dad. I remember you said something about that. What was it? Jesus, Lord, help me. You had came back mom with that. She wanted you to take a cook for the 4th of July. Did you guys cook on the grill? I heard you say you was going to take out something, and then your daughter wants you to cook. Once in, I'm glad you're still here. I thought you was gone, sweetie. Yep, the 31st. Mm-hmm. My grandfather, rest in heaven, his birthday is August 18th. My ex-husband, birthday August 18th. Oh, anyway, my uncle, my mama's brother, July the 24th, he's Uncle Ripley, he's a Leo. Tree Lynn, is she her birthday in September or August? I think she said September. Yeah, I was the only summer baby out of the parents, 11 kids. Oh my goodness, wow. 11 kids, what a beautiful, large family. My mother side of the house has 15, but my grandma lost two babies from miscarriage. And then my other grandmother, she had 14 and lost three babies. So big families back in them days. Yes, big families. And my mother, she's a beautiful, I ain't gonna tell her because she would kill me if I did. You don't tell nobody age, girl, especially a woman. You know that's rude. Yes, ma'am. It's good for you to know, but you ain't gotta tell everybody else, because I look fabulous, beautiful, and I want people to know how old I am. But I thank God every day, but they don't need to know. Those are her words. didn't grow up with any of them but two until I was 10, then was alone. Okay. I feel you. Yes, 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 yes. I have never lied about my age. I have been blessed to survive my 56 years. Yeah, my mother, she doesn't lie about her age. I mean, the thing about it is my mother don't believe in people coming up asking her age. She's like, that is none of your business. If I want you to know my age, I would tell you my age. Don't you think you are wrong for asking me my age? You ask women, ladies, how old they are. You think that's politically correct? And the person who ever asked, like, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You look beautiful. I just wanted to know. Well, she's like, you know what? I thank God for my age, but you don't need to know. Those are her words. And I guarantee you, don't come ask how old she is anymore. Oh, this is just my mom. She'll tell you, though. You know, she'll tell you, you know, she get real close to you. You know, she'll let you know how old she is. She just don't Her words is, my business ain't everybody's business. That's how she put it. It never bothered me someone asking, LOL, but I do know the older generation don't like being asked. Yeah, honey. You know, they got them standards and, you know, the way they like doing things. So, you know, if I come across and talk to an older person or whatever, and I just give them that respect. You don't want to ask them, I don't want to ask them. Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. Yeah. Three people in the building, 12 thumbs up. Y'all, excuse me, I'm going to go to the little girl's room, pay my water bill, come back and put my clothes on, and we're going to figure out how to make sure this meat is good. And, you know, we're going to sit down and talk. You guys got to go to bed, no problem, because soon I'll be going to bed, too. So we can get back up and do the skin again, and somebody else is live. I'm back. Yeah, right now it's like 10:06. In about 2 minutes, I'm gonna get up and put my breakfast on and turn the meat over and let him come eat. I'm full. I am full from that cake, and I just nibble a little piece, but I'm gonna eat some more of that, a little bit more piece of barbecue. And take me a hot bath and unwind and start this YouTube journey again. Starting with Auntie Mama all the way up. I love y'all may think I'm telling a story, but this is honest God truth. When I get up early in the morning, I don't look for the news. I look for a cup of coffee, Auntie Mama and her crew. Because honey, she bring the smoke. When I say that godly love and she keep you in line, Auntie Mama, I got nothing but love for you, baby. Because I'm telling you, that woman is anointed and blessed and highly favored. Or God, her Uncle Daddy, how they get up on YouTube and share the love. You may be having the worst day ever. You go to Auntie Mama's place, you're going to come back. You're going to be like, you know what? Forget whatever was bothering me. It's going to be a good day. Yes, indeed. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. And it's good, you know, sharing, you know, the word of God over YouTube. Because we can turn something negative to something positive. And that's why I love doing what I do. Get the numbers, honey. Who cares? Who cares about the numbers? I'm saying for me. Some people do, but for me, no, I don't care. When I make it, I'll make it. But until then, I'm just going to enjoy the beautiful people and love this journey. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Y'all, let me get them put these vegetables on while I talk myself. And be done. Forget that I need to finish this meal here. So we got hungry people ready to eat. Especially Ronnie, he has to get up and work tomorrow. Even though he's getting ready to retire, he says, I know he's happy about that.
So, let's get this man something to eat so he can go to work tomorrow. So right now, I'm going to lima beans, right? Yep, lima beans. Get a good old can of lima beans in. Oh, these cans of lima beans right here. Normally, I love lima beans. I like to cook them in the Instant Pot. Yes, I do. It was lima beans I was cooking, I remember. But tonight, we're going to take this bad boy, open up the can, put it in the pot, put a little bit of water, and we're going to put some butter and salt and let it go. And I'm going to cook my corn the same way, too. And then I'm gonna check on this meat. Let me do my pocket stuff, y'all. So, go ahead and put that up there. Yep. Yeah, we're supposed to get rain all this week. And it's supposed to be getting hot. The evening day is supposed to be going up. And we know it's summer. But I say, the weather that's coming is not like it was 2 weeks ago. So I'm thankful to see the rain and see a little bit of humidity, because I'm telling you, I think it was like last Sunday or Sunday before last, when the temperature was like, oh my God, heat index of 107, 108. It was 101 here in the Chesterfield area. I was like, what in the world? It ain't even summer yet. So they let you know it's going to be a hot summer. But I'm thankful. Whatever the good Lord brings, I'm thankful. But should it be brought you through yesterday, he'll bring you through tomorrow and today. I know. I think I was at Piggly Wiggly or something. And somebody said, it sure is hot out there. He said, I tell you what, it ain't hot as hell, is it? And the person said, you know what? You right about that, bro. You hit that on the point. It ain't hot as hell, so I'm thankful for this 100 degrees. And I started thinking, I bust out laughing because he was actually telling the truth. Who would want to be in hell? I know I wouldn't. Lord knows. That's just heat that we can't even begin to imagine, they say, according to Revelation. So we got that open. Go ahead and pour that in a pot. The lima beans are already smelling good, though. I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of onions in it and a little bit of butter, salt. Then do his thing about 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and hey, we'll be ready to eat. But tomorrow when I do cook, and whenever I cook now, it won't be this way, y'all. It's just because of the power outage. So, you know, sometimes you just gotta, you know, keep going on no matter what has happened. So you can be successful and get things accomplished that way. So anyway, that being said, I can't believe it's not butter. I love this stuff. It just put a bling in my bling. I love it. Can't believe it's not butter. I'm going to put a teaspoon in because he has to watch what he eats because, honey, he's just a health nut. And that's good. He spent time in the military, too. That's what we do. And now he's being successful to go ahead and retire from the job that he's on now. So that is truly amazing. God can bless you. Such a way when you have accomplishment of retirement. So I salute all you people that is retired here, Auntie Mama, etc. Auntie Mama still work, but yet still I know that she's at the point where she has options, she can work, but she don't have to want to work. And when you get that point, that's a blessing. How many people can simply say they don't spend over 10 years or 15, 20 years on a job? A lot of people that can't say that. So I'm going ahead to put my stove on a, I'll keep it on 6 for that. Yeah, I think the only thing I'm going to cook tonight is lima beans. And tomorrow, you know, I'll cook corn just because it's getting late and I'm getting a little tired and I got to clean up the kitchen. And I want to sit down and talk to y'all before y'all go. And then, you know, we'll just go from there. So I'm going to go ahead and put the salt and pepper in here. I was going to cut a little bit of onion, red. But now we're going to do it old school. Yes, but red. Just about. Hold on. Give me about 10 more minutes to be ready to eat. Put a little bit of salt in there. Yeah, I was going to cook some corn, but I changed my mind, y'all. It's a little late. Put some black pepper and salt in. Then turn the stove down a little bit because, you know, I just got this stove, so I'm trying to get used to it. And so far, I'm liking it. I really am. And it's self-cleaning, too, so that's a plus. I didn't put that much salt, just a little bit. And what I'm going to do is add a little bit of water, just a little bit, not much. And let it do its thing. Put all my dishes to the side. I can wash when I'm done. Normally, I be washing the whole time I'm cooking, but just for tonight and tonight only, I'm going to let the meal finish up. And then after I get done talking, I'll go ahead and do the dishes and take my hot bath and take my butt to bed. Ooh, this has been one of them. I didn't get that much sleep last night because we just partied all weekend for my birthday. And my family, we decided we like to party until we can't party anymore. You know, in a good perspective, you know, my family loves to celebrate birthdays. So I'm going to go ahead and put a pot over this and let it do what it do. Then I'm going to check on the meat, too. Meat should be ready to go. Oh God, I gotta get low. I'm so sore. Oh. All right, y'all. That part on there.
Ready?
Yep. He ready, man. This man ready to eat, y'all. Man ain't ready yet.
Yes, no, it's not.
But it'll be ready in just a minute. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this out. And you know what? The meat is ready. The meat is ready. Put that on the side like that. Turn this stove off. Turn it off. I gotta figure out how to turn the stove off, y'all. Yeah, so. Time off. There we go. I'm just trying to put it on just to warm it up. Meat and taste it for myself. I'm gonna sit down and talk to y'all for a minute. Let's see if I get a small sauce in here. Y'all, I tell you what, that meat smells so good. Oh my God. That barbecue on this is gonna cut me a little piece of it just to taste it, you guys can see. So I'm gonna talk to y'all for a minute. And it's just so tender too. Put that down, but I don't need that. Oh wow. And I'm glad I put that extra foil on it because cleanup is gonna be so easy. This is falling off the bone, y'all. I gotta put it in pieces to get it. I'm coming, y'all. There we go. So here we have it, y'all. Taste test. And I gotta cover it back up too. See, that's what it looks like. I'm gonna do a little small sample because it's hot. And I just wanna see how it tastes. Amen, y'all. Auntie Mama, good night. I love you. Thank you for being here. Thought it looked like a different stove. Yeah, it's a different stove, Alberta Stella. Rudy, what's going on? 907, which is in Texas. It's 1007. I hope you guys are safe in Texas. Hope you didn't have that much impact from Hurricane Beryl. Everybody's safe and, you know, doing, you know, everything. Everybody's good. Go check the meat, girl. I am out, brother. Eating it right now, baby. Eating it right now. So, guys, I know you guys have been this 1 hour and 58 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and do my outro because I know some of you guys got to get some rest. And I'm probably going to keep this up and running, just get my watch time in because I'm not going to stay up live streaming like I did last night or early this morning. Went to Mama, I'll be there in the place at 5:30 to see your lovely face. And all the friends that come in, you know how we're going to do it. We're going to sit there and we're going to have us a good time. But anyway, this is so good, y'all. Yes, sir. Is it ready? Yes, it's almost ready. Just waiting on the beans. You come on, get some of this meat. Come on, eat. But anyway, y'all, thank y'all for being here, sharing the recipe with me, sharing the love. I love you guys so much. If I am awake, I will be there, Auntie Mama. Yeah, Auntie Mama, we come to see you, baby. I know I'm going to be there. My brother says she's awake. She'll be there, too. Auntie Mama know how I am. Auntie Mama ain't had my coffee yet, and I will slip. It's like, I know, girl. Good night. Oh, God bless.
Thank you guys for being here. Mm. Trying not to be rude, y'all. Much love. Instead of doing watch time hours a night, y'all, y'all know what? I'm going to thank God for what I have and let the Lord work on it. How about that? Numbers don't mean anything. It's love. I want you guys to have a wonderful, wonderful Monday night. And I pray that the Lord watches over you and keep you, because he will. If you ever need me for anything, just reach out. StacyRobinson27@gmail.com. Find me. And I promise you guys, in my description, all my stuff is going to be there. I've just been trying to do the BBQ thing, my numbers up, but I'm old school. Definitely got to have a way with people to reach you, okay? So with that being said, guys, much love. Blessings, blessings to all. And remember, remember, if you always, always know that you got a friend in me. Until then, people, salute. God bless. Y'all, this meat is so good. I got to clean this kitchen up, though. See you guys tomorrow. Good night.